Hey, welcome back. It is a great way to see the works of hundreds of Ohio's artists. The 7th annual Made in Ohio Art and Craft Festival is this weekend. Event organizer Renee Flynn and director of Hale Farm and Village, Jason Klein, are here with more on the festival. Welcome to the both of you.
Thanks. Thank you for having us.
You brought some goodies. So, but first, before we get to them, this is the 10th year for it, right? And this is kind of your baby. So tell us how it all evolved.
Well, I had been going to many, many festivals with my own art and finding out that there was no festival that featured just Ohio artists. I felt really strongly that we needed to have a festival that featured Ohio artists.
And obviously it's progressed over the 10 years.
Oh, it started out with 35 vendors at Hale Farm, of course. We picked Hale Farm as a venue because of the historic arts and crafts that they have there. And it has evolved to 170 artists.
Wow.
Ohio food, beer and wine, and all sorts of entertainment.
How fun. All right, so let's talk about some of the products you brought, because where do you want to start? There's so much to talk. You want to start with the painting?
So we have, this is a photographer, a couple different photographers that we have that come to the festival, Bob Tunkins, and we have quite a few photographers that come and feature a lot of different types of photography. Scenic as and
here it
such.
Looks like a painting to me.
Isn't it amazing?
That's truly amazing. Wow. Yeah.
And then of course we have woodworkers, so I brought some different types of woodworkers. This is some very rustic woodworkers, some beautiful cutting boards. Mm-hmm. Do you know what this is?
It looks like it would smash something.
It's a bottle opener.
It's a bottle opener. Hello.
And we have all sorts of food represented at the festival.
I see that. Can we talk about the chocolate? Because I didn't miss that.
So this is the Bomb Chocolate, and they are coming with all sorts of different delightful chocolates. You're welcome to try any of those. And then we have Nosh Butters, which is a local Cleveland company. Oh, does it taste good?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, anything with chocolate on it tastes really good. All right, these are infused with alcohol too?
Yes, they are. It's called the Bomb. And then we have textile artists. So this artist created this purse out of men's suits.
Wow.
So you can see all sorts of details. Here's the breast pocket in the back there. Tuck your cell phone in there.
Interesting. Okay.
And then we have some very unique artists. These here in the front are from Exotica. They are made out of eggshells. So there's tiny little pieces of eggshells that are dyed.
Really?
And they make, well, there's a box and then a switch plate cover.
Okay. Talk about this scarf that's gracing the table, because you can have that done.
Right. So at the festival, one of our artists, you can create your own silk scarf. And there's a couple of examples of the silk scarves that she has. But you can actually make one at the festival.
That's really fun. I want to get to you, Jason, because I want to leave you out. But some of the stuff that you brought, this is your baby, because this is actually done at Hale Farm.
That's right. So Crafts and Trades at Hale Farm has been going on for 61 years.
Wow.
From it becoming a living history museum.
Sure.
So there are glass blowers, blacksmiths, potters, spinners and weavers. So a good representation of all the different vendors that are going to be at the festival. And demonstrations that go on year-round.
Right.
We have these great local artisans who produce stuff that we not only sell in our marketplace, but also that live in the historic structures throughout the properties.
So. I was telling you, in grade school, I remember going and just making those candles.
Yeah.
You know, it's one of my favorite parts. So people can, it's very interactive.
Absolutely.
Right.
And new this year, we wanted to bring those experiences to people who visit the festival with a series of workshops. So we're offering a couple different tracks, paper marbling, wool felting, and cloth painting. And it's $30. You have to pre-register for a workshop, halefarm.org. But it gets you into the festival for the whole day. It's an hour session. You learn how to do these things, and then you can do them at home after you leave.
That's so fun. So this is happening this weekend. The Made in Ohio Art and Craft Festival runs again this weekend at Hale Farm and Village from noon until 5 on Friday, 10 to 5 on both Saturday and Sunday. So it's an event you don't want to miss. If you want to find kind of those unique items, no, you can't find anywhere else. Plus, you're putting money into local stuff in local businesses.
Celebrate Ohio, buy local.
There you go. All right, all the information will be on our website, fox8.com. Renee and Jason, thank you for coming.
Thanks.
Thank you.
You don't want this back to you.
No, enjoy that.
All right, good. All right.